we'll move, excuse me, we'll move on to agenda item 7A. This is one of our bid items, and this is the Sprayfield expansion phase one, Mr. Stallings.
Yes, sir. Utility staff submitted an expansion plan to Georgia Utility several months ago to expand the Sprayfield and accommodate increased flow due to our growth. Currently, we're permitted for 2 million gallons a day, and this will get, move us up to about 3 million a day. The additional capacity requires approximately 150 acres of Sprayfield. These fields have been cleared and ready for the piping and the sprinklers to be added. Staff advertised and received 4 bids ranging from $3,369,213.71 to a little over 4 million. Southeast Connections out of Conyers, Georgia submitted the low bid. Staff, along with Carter and Sloop Engineering, checked out the references for the company and everything was positive. Staff recommends approval and authorize the chairman to sign the contract with Southeast Connections for $3,369,213.71.
Any questions for Mr. Stout?
I have one thing, I guess maybe Paige or Stephanie can answer it. Realizing, I just noticed that funding is coming from ARPA. ARPA funds can be used for disaster relief as well, to my understanding, right?
I'm not aware of that. Our funds have already been obligated. So we had a reporting deadline quite some time ago that passed that we had to submit how we had obligated those funds. And so ours have already been obligated moving through for these projects.
You happen to, Stephanie, happen to know how much more access to ARPA we have or ARPA funds we have?
We can get that balance for you this afternoon. But so far, it's all either been obligated for water and sewer or for the jail project. So there's not extra in there to.
There's no other ARPA funding. Paige is saying is that it's either already been obligated or already utilized. There's none set there waiting.
I guess the question would be if we knew how much we have left in splash regarding utilities, that this may possibly could satisfy as well.
We can definitely get that splash balance for you. Stephanie should have that. We work on that as we prepare a recommendation for splash line for you. So not only can we do that, but also the projects that are already underway, we can get that list for you as well.
Thanks.
Sure.
Any other questions?
Mr. Stella, how many more gallons per day can we get to our current facility down there? If we could expand more.
If we could expand more, I think our projected, now this would require additional holding pond and a lot more stuff, but we have been told probably up to about 4 million.
And we're currently at?
We're currently at 2, and this will take us to 3.
But your spray field capacity total, future good. Expansion and all is 4?
Yes, sir. Correct. That's right.
Yeah.
And that would be current fields that are being used for agriculture, and it would be removing some of the pine trees.
Yeah.
And just to be clear, that would be a separate add-on project, not a part of this.
Yeah, that's not been approved by the committee up to the board, but that's what the engineers have felt like we could get to. That's what I'm asking.
And if you all would like for us to check with EPD regarding that, just let us know, because that's a conversation that when we tried to have with them once before, they weren't altogether favorable. They are not permitting new LESs or expansion of LESs at the rate that they were before. But if that's a direction that you guys feel strongly about, we will certainly go to that and see what we can get.
Well, we can do that, but I think in reality, we've had these discussions at retreats and at other work sessions, but the direction that we need to be moving forward is in consideration is a treatment facility rather than land application site. We know that that's coming, so we need to be preparing for that now that it's always coming. All right, agenda item.